Would you like to introduce our first player of this
third for sure. set? For sure. Once again, for the third time tonight, on Ancient System. In the bottom left-hand corner, the blue Terran player for Sarstorm Gaming. Give it up for Nicoract.
And his opponent for Berserker Esports, the Zerg that Linglad dreams to be until he realizes the coffee is too cold. It's Mixu. Oh, sheesh, that was a good line, man.
One day.
Oh my god. That
I
was...
say one day, but I'll never reach that sort of levels, man. These guys are too good for me, man.
Don't worry, we'll showcase your gameplay if we ever manage to organize a CSO peep mode night or something.
The boss actually called me out today and said the last time you played a 1v1, Jono, she was such
actually. What do you mean? The last time he played a 1v1 was against me. Recently in March.
If you look at my ladder history, it says I don't want to admit how many months ago it was.
Like what, 8, 9 months?
More.
Oh, 10, 11? What, 11?
Yeah, I say. 11, dude. Oh.
Almost a year. Don't worry, one game a year. That's the least.
That's all you need to be 6k. 5.96k.
There you go. Just don't wake up.
Yeah, just don't wake up, man. That's the dream. Living the dream.
Literally.
Living the dream. Oh my god.
Can we twist this more?
But yeah, man. No twist in this opener. Stock standard 16, 18, 17 out of Mixu.
Oh, I see what you did there.
Everything middle of the road. And I mean, this just shows respect between these two players. And no disrespect going for like a proxy 3 racks or something. You know, it's just standard opener. Which is okay. You know, I respect you and we're gonna go at this.
I respect you, I'll shove 2 battle cruisers in your face, don't worry.
I mean, I'm waiting for that, dude. That was a build, okay? That was a build.
I mean, that's the standard for Nicoract, okay? Like, that's my line there. If you would say, like, oh, that's not exactly standard. That's standard. The question is for who, and look at that, the quick 3 CC coming in for Nicoract as well.
Fucking first into double BC, here we go.
I mean, I think he did it with a dirt command center as well, no? Am I crazy?
He's gone factory into... There we go, awesome.
So he's command center factory. In the starport now, okay.
Yeah, so let's see. Let's see what he wants to do. Or if against Mixu, he's also going to go for that double Banshee. Double click Banshee.
Okay, I'm waiting for a tech lab to pop up. I'm waiting for a tech lab and... Just look at where... Okay, there's a tech lab. Okay, so... Linglad, I have a theory here. He put that barracks there because he needs the tech lab.
It's going to be a quick swap over when the starport finishes up.
Yeah, that's what I'm expecting
still
here.
Still no fusion core, though, so...
Yeah, but he needs a starport. He needs a starport for it. Oh, no.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
I mean, oh, no for Mixu, obviously, but... Oh, yes, for us, because we're going to have some fun here.
You say, oh, no, I'll say, oh, yes. Man.
Oh, yes.
Mixu still hasn't fired up links.
Is it too late to change my vote, sir? I'd like to change my vote to, oh, yes.
Denied.
Just like the Overlord is going to get denied by that Viking.
That's for sure, dude. That's for sure. It's going to be a Liberator. All right. Mixu still doesn't have link speed. But with these Hellions, Nicoract's going to get the scouts off that. Mixu's going for a roach timing attack, but this Liberator's going to come in clutch, man.
Ah, yes. Indeed.
Absolutely nothing shoots up. And unless there's a couple of Ravages on the way here for Mixu, there's going to be no way of dealing with this Liberator, which, I mean, set up defensively is just
going to
be...
Actually, the Ravagers are going to deal with it just fine. I mean, forcing the Unseat from the Liberators... That's going to be really, really important. Now the Hellions come back at back home. Lib is not yet finished. Viking lands, but he needs to be careful. Talking about respect, man, that is a disrespectful 3-base push here. Shouldn't end the game, though, that's for sure. Nicoract has 3 command centers, so it shouldn't be an issue, to be honest.
Yeah, not at all. I think just with a little reposition. Okay, so there's three Ravagers here, so Nicorak can't actually push that Liberator too far. Okay.
That was nice, Biles. Literally supply block, insta supply into the supply block. Gets the lib.
Yep. Yeah, those extra Ravagers, but now these Ravagers are a little bit more squishy against these Hellions. Okay, three Ravagers and a Roach over here. Let's see.
Yeah, they're not
splash
armored,
can
I think, right? They're not
yep,
armored.
Correct. Correct, so the Hellions are pretty good against these Ravagers.
Okay, but actually Mixu did a lot of damage with this build, in my opinion. Look at the resources lost, man.
Yeah,
2200. Basically 2200 and 1000 more in just the minerals, so...
Yeah, yeah.
And if you look at it, it's basically mineral units that were lost. The good thing is that Nicorak can... count on is that he has three command centers and he only lost four workers, so he's gonna have a decent economy. He's gonna have mules for days basically with three command centers, and basically he didn't have his steam timing denied or something.
Yeah,
does he have e-base? He has double e-base. He hasn't started his upgrades yet. He's trying to do some damage across the map, but yeah, these roaches are too tanky, man.
I think Nicorak just did a solid job of holding that push by Mixu, and yes, okay, so there's the upgrades. Upgrades kicking. Upgrades on the way. Yeah, Stim is done. Combat shield's on the way. I think Nicorak's in a pretty decent position. Yes, Mixu's up almost 20 workers, 15 workers at the moment.
Yeah, but that's the Zerg mechanics. I mean, Mixu kind of like had a couple of roaches remaining from that last push, I think. He did not move them across. Now he has 12 roaches and 6 more on the way, so he's gonna have 18 roaches, man. He's looking for a max out timing on 4 bases, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, and now I'd really like to see Nicorak.
This is kind of like a dark build. This really looks like a dark build, honestly.
15 roaches on the way. Mix is going for the kill, man.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, definitely looks like a dark build, because dark usually doesn't do it off of 66 drones. He usually does it off of 70 something. I'm not exactly sure of the number, but I saw him do that because it still has that potential transition.
Does he not do it for the extra gas? Like the gas is 7 and 8 on the fourth base. So it's not so much about the mineral income, but it's about the gas income to do this huge roach push.
Yeah, I was thinking obviously Nicorak, need gas.
Like I was thinking Nicorak should really be making banshees now. Obviously, he has no idea this attack's coming. Nicorak's moving out, but
This is not going to be great for Nicorak, honestly. I mean, okay. Mixu's going to see it, and question is, actually, I like this. Mixu just splits the army. He's going to go for this counterattack while he's going to deal with the army at home against Nicorak. Ooh, that's a couple of bios that's going to land on some of the frontal roaches. And there we go. GG's called from Nicorak. Wow, man, that was a brilliant build.